Tommy in Urbana, welcome.
Hi, thank you. I have a question regarding our Blessed Mother.
Okay.
I have many Protestant friends and recently a lot of Protestant family members. And I take a lot of criticism and a lot of hits, it seems.
You take hits?
Yeah.
Okay. Metaphorical ones, hits. I think she means.
Okay.
Regarding our praying the rosary and praying to Mother Mary,
okay.
They consider it idolatry.
Really? There's no actual idol involved.
So, Tommy, I want to get you a good answer. So why do Catholics pray the rosary, and why is it not Mariolatry, right? That's the question.
Yes.
Okay.
Do they use the word Mariolatry, or do they use the word idolatry?
Hold on a second. Did you hear that, Tommy? Are they saying you're idolizing Mary in some way?
Yes. I have had a friend that just flat out said that.
Okay.
You're idolatrous.
So let's talk about what an idol is, because if they're using that term, you want to be able to know how to refute it. An idol is a statue that someone perceives as a god. And so let's figure out whether you, Tommy, are an idolater. Do you have any statues of Mary?
Yes, I do.
Do you think that they're gods?
No, I believe she's the mother of God.
Then you're not an idolater. And you can explain it to your friend in terms that are just that simple, because it sounds like your friend needs a simple explanation of what idolatry is. Now, there are metaphorical forms of idolatry that don't actually involve statues. Like at one point, St. Paul talks about certain people in the ancient world who he said their stomach was their god. And, you know, he meant that they care more about sensual pleasure, particularly the pleasure of eating, than they do about the actual god. And in the ancient world, they had amazing gastronomic feats that they would perform. In fact, some people in the ancient world were so into eating that they would go eat a bunch of delicacies and then stick a feather down their throat so they'd throw it all up and could eat some more. That's a kind of disordered approach to eating that you could look at someone and say metaphorically their stomach's their god. But in the literal sense, what idolatry is it's thinking a statue is a god, and that's not what you're doing. So that deals with that part of the question, and we'll deal with the rest of it on the other side of the break.
Tommy is still there in Urbana, Illinois. Still there, Tommy?
Yes.
Okay, so Jimmy was gaining some altitude on this question of the rosary.
Yeah, so so we covered the fact of that an idol is a statue someone thinks is a god. And actually, there were statues that were used for religious purposes in the Old Testament, commanded by God, that were not idols. And you see an example of that in the case of the bronze serpent that God had when the people of Israel were being bitten by snakes. And he said, make a bronze serpent, put it on a pole, and when people look at it, they'll be able to survive the snake bite. So he used this statue to perform miracles. And since looking at a statue has no power to cure you of itself, this is a religious act that he chose to use to perform a miracle. And consequently, we see God endorsing the use of a statue in a religious act. And similarly, he had them make little statues of cherubs that he had on the lid of the Ark of the Covenant itself. And similarly, there were giant 15-foot-tall statues of cherubs in the Holy of Holies in the temple. And all of that was commanded by God. So God doesn't have a problem with using religious statuary. What he has a problem with is thinking that the religious statuary represents a divinity that doesn't exist. And you're not doing that with Mary because you recognize that Mary is a human being and not a deity. So if you want more on that, go to Catholic.com and just put in statue or idol in the search box, and you'll get more material backing up what I just said. Are there other aspects of your question that I need to cover, or does that give you what you need?
I think the other part of it is the question as to why we feel as Catholics we need to include Mary in our prayer. So, you know, something specific I had stated to me was, if you feel that you need Mary in your prayer, then you are not solid in your relationship with God. You don't feel that he's going to answer your prayers on his own.
Okay. What I would suggest in that case is ask your friend, do you ever ask anyone else to pray for you, to be your partner in prayer? And if they say yes, then I would say, well, then it doesn't sound like you're very secure in your faith in God, because you're needing to, you're thinking you need to add something to your prayers to God, or he won't answer you. And so you shouldn't be asking anybody else to pray alongside of you. And that's the consistent extension of the principle that they're trying to apply in your case with Mary. Now, we know that that's not a correct principle, because when you read in Scripture, it talks about praying for other people. We are encouraged by Jesus to pray even for our enemies. And so God obviously expects us to pray for other people, and that obviously has an effect, because if it didn't have an effect, he wouldn't want us to do it. And so consequently, it is God's will to grant some requests when nobody prays and he just does it because he's generous, or to when one person is praying for themselves, or when someone else is praying for them. And we don't know what goes in which category, because that's all God's choice. So we do know that it's his will to answer prayers sometimes when more than one person is praying for something. And if that's true, then there's a question of, who do we want as our prayer partners? And you could say to your friend, okay, if you had Mary right here, Jesus' mom, right here on earth, would you want her as a prayer partner if you could ask her to pray for you alongside of you? And I know I would, and if your friend is honest, your friend will probably say, yeah, I would want Jesus' mom as my prayer partner. Well, as a Catholic, we think we can have that she doesn't need to be here on earth in order to hear our prayers directly, because she's in heaven and God can let her know about our prayers. And so your friend may or may not agree with that, but they should be able to see that merely believing God shares our prayer requests with those in heaven so that they can pray alongside of us as our partners does not mean we have weak faith in God or anything like that, any more than the fact that your friend asks other people here on earth to pray alongside of her or him means that she or he has weak faith in God.
Uh-huh.
Okay, Tony?
Is mm-hmm. there a specific Bible verse
that
give them that would show them or state to them that it is okay, or a reason for why?
There are multiple Bible verses that deal with aspects of this question. If there was a single one that would be convincing to all Protestants, this issue would not come up.
Yeah.
So you can only go so far, and don't fall into the trap of thinking, I have to have a Bible verse. The burden of proof is on the person who wants someone to change their opinion. So if they want you to change your opinion, they've got the burden of proof. You don't have to prove anything to them. And you're totally entitled as a Catholic to say, this is what we believe, and it's rooted in Scripture, but it's not all expressly stated in Scripture. Having said that, just to go a little further, there are Bible verses that pertain to this. We see, for example, in the book of Revelation, in chapter 5, verse 8, and in chapter 8, verses 3 through 4, we see the saints and angels in heaven offering God the prayers of the saints on earth. So we have evidence that they are serving as our prayer partners. Furthermore, if you look in at the end of the book of James, it talks about how the prayers of a righteous man avail much, or other translations will say there is great power or in the prayers of a righteous man, or they're great in their effects. Well, those in heaven are about as righteous as it gets. Mm-hmm. I mean, they've already had their purification complete. They're holy and utterly righteous. And consequently, they make really good prayer partners. And so we're just taking that principle from James and applying it in a more general way. Again, if you need more information on all that, go to Catholic.com, type the word saints into the search box.
Yeah. If you're looking for a single book, Tommy, get Tim Staples' Behold Your Mother, also available at aforesaid website, catholic.com. Thank you very much for the call.